Alright, so welcome to my new series. I'm gonna be going over rappers, not just rappers. I'm gonna be going over a bunch of artists and their discographies. I'm just gonna give you guys a quick little background of this. About half a year ago, I realized I wasn't listening to enough music. There was too many iconic albums that I missed out on, iconic artists, and just music in general. I really just had my own little artist bubble and stayed within that. But I decided I'm gonna try to branch out. And since then, I finished like 5 discographies, but I wanna get back to doing it. I could have a lot more done. I'm not gonna tell you guys which ones because I plan on making future videos about them, but I was just letting you know that I did hear a few. And if there's some underrated discography or like anything y'all want me to make a video on, please tell me. I want to listen to your favorite artists, your least favorite artists, amazing albums, like just give it to me all. Pause. And before we get deep into this, and I might say this in all the future videos when I make these, I'm not a professional music listener, nigga. I'm just listening to artists, giving them ratings based off my ears, nigga. Look at the channel name, Trey. That's not me asking you not to disagree with my opinions. That's me asking you not to dick ride me. Just to give you guys a better understanding of the music I like, my favorite artists in no order, and this does not mean best, this just means favorite: Juice WRLD, Cole, Youngboy, Uzi, Kanye, JID, and G Herbo. Clearly, I love rap. I honestly really only listen to rap, so most of these discographies are gonna be by rap artists, but I do love R&B too, and not the new age R&B, even though Brent is pretty good. I'm talking more like Lauryn Hill, Jill Scott, Janet Jackson, like you know what I'm talking about. I won't lie, I also do fuck with rock on the low key. So literally suggest anything, old school, new school, mid school, doesn't matter. Fucking country music, gospel music, I don't care, I just wanna listen to shit. Also, disclaimer, I will be calling some of your favorite rappers ass. I will be calling some of your favorite albums absolute garbage juice. When I'm doing that, I'm not saying it's objectively ass. I'm sure that, you know, like, you enjoy it. It's just not for my ears. Unless that shit really sucks, then I'm for sure calling it objectively ass. Alright, so now let me tell you guys how I'm gonna be ranking these albums. We're gonna be using a tier list, the S tier list. I'm pretty sure all of you guys know what that is. S is the highest tier in that, then it goes down to A, B, C, D, E to F. So there's no confusion. S means like once in a lifetime GOAT type shit. And F means once in a lifetime just piece of fuck. Horrible garbage music. And because it's once in a lifetime, there shouldn't be a lot of albums in either of those tiers. And at the end, I'll do a recap on the artists, how I feel about the albums overall and them overall, and really just give you guys an opinion. If I confused you, I'm sorry. It's gonna make a lot more sense when I start doing it. Alright, bro, that's enough chit chat. Let's get into our first artist. As a Chicago native and the greatest of all time, and honestly the reason I started all this, my first video will be on Mr. Kanye West. Now, I ain't gonna lie, I'm a little late on the Ye train, but that's what I did this for, so I could catch up on these supposed GOATs. And let me tell you, this nigga is a GOAT. Kanye's one of those people where you don't remember where you first heard him. He was just always there. Well, at least if you're like my age. But I never really got into him. I remember when Life of Pablo dropped, and I feel like I heard a little bit of it, but I didn't really tune in for him. 2 years later, Ye dropped, and this is while Kanye was going through that whole like thing where he starts talking too much to the media and everybody starts calling him crazy and shit. So I was like, you know what, let me hear this shit, let me see what this nigga's about. Fire. It was short, nice for my attention span, and I overall was just pleased with that album. I didn't end up going back listening to any of his old shit after that. I was just rocking with Ye. But when I decided I wanted to do this discography thing, he was the first on my list. And here we are. Y'all know the man, no more introduction. Let's get straight to it. College Dropout. Now look, I understand this is high on a lot of people's lists. It grew on me after like the second and third listen. At first I wasn't really fucking with it, but like I said, it started growing on me. It's not a bad album, but I wouldn't say it's like super good. To me, it's only fair to smack it right dab in the middle and put it at C tier. I'm not gonna be doing these like upper and lower, but if I was, it would be like upper C tier. Top 3 songs to me on that album would have to be All Falls Down, Two Words, and then Never Let Me Down. Through the Wire and Slow Jams are also very hard, honorable mentions. The thing is, when I think about my favorite songs on this album, I really like these songs, like I can't lie to you. But the ones outside that bubble, they're kind of mid to me, I can't lie. And it's not a lot, but there's not enough in this album for me to bump it up to B. So yeah, College Dropout, I'm gonna have it C tier. Now, Late Registration. First listen, I kind of felt the same way I feel about College Dropout. I re-listened like a few months after, and I was completely wrong. I don't know what I was doing while listening to it the first time. Late Registration is hard as hell, I can't lie. If you told me College Dropout was better, I'm not gonna downright call you like an idiot or something, cause it's all preference, but I personally just think Late Registration clears. Top three favorite songs on here would have to be We Major, Gold Digger, and Touch the Sky. In my personal opinion, there's not a single miss on this album. Like, it low-key could be A tier. Actually, it might be A tier. I'm over here looking at it on my phone like, this shit might be A tier. I'll come back to it, but for right now, I'm gonna have it at B. Graduation. We're not gonna spend too long on this album, bro. It's an easy S. Shit's fuego. This album made me realize that this nigga is different. Every single song on that shit is a hit. And not like one of those just really good song hits, like a classical fucking hit. For me, this album is 1A and 1B for Kanye's greatest album of all time. Favorite three songs on this shit: Flashing Lights, I Wonder, probably The Glory. Yeah, so overall, this album is 100% S tier, and I really don't know how you could think otherwise. 808s and Heartbreak. Bro, I'ma keep it short. This is not a good album. The songs are dragged out. This nigga Kanye is screaming in my ear. RoboCop sounds like it was made for a Disney movie. Yeah, I'm just not a fan of this. I was reading some Reddit posts and they were saying like it's one of those experimental shits. And it's like, am I supposed to read it and then like it because it's supposed to be experimental? Yeah, no, it's just not one of his best works, bro. However, Heartless and Amazing, 10 out of 10, amazing songs. Love them. For the third best song, I'd probably say You Will or Coldest Winter. It's a tie between those two, but both are mid, I'm not gonna lie. So I'll probably give this album like an E. But boy, did that nigga come back with an S. My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy is 1A and 1B with Graduation for Kanye's best album. I really can't choose which is better. It just depends what mood I'm in. But yeah, nah, no debate, bro. This is definitely an S tier. Favorite songs gotta be All of the Lights, Devil in a New Dress, and Blame Game, cause that nigga John Legend is a motherfucking goat. I damn near gotta go through his discography, bro, cause that nigga raw as hell. But hell yeah, that shit a 10 out of 10. S tier, everything, just put it there. I'm gonna skip over Watch the Throne. I think this series is just gonna be mainly for solo albums and shit. So in that case, we got Yeezus up next. Now look, I've seen a lot of people say that Yeezus isn't good. And I ain't gonna lie, I completely disagree. This shit nice. Like, it's a solid album to me. Like, I wouldn't say it's some standout album, but it's definitely not ass. Now that first song, that you can have that. That shit garbage. But honestly, besides that and maybe two other songs, I like everything on there. Top three songs. Obviously Bound to Blood on the Leaves, and I really like New Slaves. Yeah, I'm comfortable putting this shit at C tier. I know y'all gonna disagree, but yeah, I feel like this is on College Dropout level. Coming up, we got Life of Pablo. Let me start out by saying I'm a little biased because this is my favorite Kanye album. And I don't even know if that's me being biased, because a lot of people like this album. It's a classic. The nigga got Kendrick Lamar on it. The feeling I get when this album comes on is unmatched. It got straight heat, bangers, hits, whatever you want to call it. Top three favorite songs would have to be No Parties in LA, 30 hours, and then probably Feedback. I ain't gonna lie, I'm gonna put this album in A tier. Well deserving. I could listen to it all day every day. And that brings me to the album previously mentioned, Yay, my first Kanye album. This album has a soft spot in my heart, I can't lie. It's really short, but it kind of fits, if that makes sense. And that's what she said. But yeah, every single song on here is like a 9. My top three is probably Violent Crimes, Thought About Killing You, and All Mine. If it was longer and it stayed consistent, I swear to God, this could have been S tier, but it wasn't. So I'm gonna give it a cool B, which means I guess I could have Late Registration at an A. Jesus Is King. We're not gonna stay long on this. In my opinion, the album honestly started off pretty decent, but it kind of fell off after that. I'm pretty sure a majority of Kanye fans don't like this album. I heard people say it's rushed, lazy, the mixing is bad, just a whole lot of shit. And listening to it while hearing that about it, I'm not gonna lie, made it a little bit worse. But I mean, it's a gospel album, like, it's not a rap album. So I don't really count it against Kanye too much, but this shit's like a D. The first three songs are the best three songs to me, but in reverse order. So Follow God, Selah, and Every Hour. Alright, moving on to Donda. This shit is a masterpiece. Really, really good album. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I don't know why anybody was ever saying CLB comes close to this. This shit almost put tears in my eye. Nigga making a whole song for Kobe and shit. And remember when he was previewing the album by performing it in that stadium? Shit was genius, raw as hell. I love the album. My favorite songs would have to be Heaven and Hell, Believe What I Say, and probably Moon. I wouldn't put it S tier, but that shit definitely A. Now, I didn't listen to Donda 2 because it's not on Spotify, but all my homies said it's ass. I'm not calling it ass because I haven't listened to it, but that's their opinion. They think it's ass. Let me know what you guys think of this shit. I'm probably not going to end up listening to it. So we're going to end the rankings right there. At S tier, we got Graduation and My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. At A tier, we got Late Registration, Donda, and Life of Pablo. In the B tier, we got Ye. Move down to C tier, you'll see College Dropout and Yeezus. At D tier, we got Jesus is King. Why is that so hard to say? The Gospel Album. That's what we got at D tier. And lastly, all the way in E, you'll see that shit-ass 808s and Heartbreak album. Overall, obviously, Kanye is one of the greatest to ever do it. Absolutely amazing discography. The nigga's a god, what can I say? There will only be one Kanye. That's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, we could keep doing more videos like this. So again, suggest some artists in the comments for me to listen to. New videos every Monday and Thursday, bitch. And I'm probably gonna drop some music that'll be on, like, Apple Music and Spotify soon. Be on the lookout for that. But that's really all I got for y'all today, man. You know the routine, bro. Like, comment, subscribe, all that shit. And yeah, I'm out.